the impact of change and the challenges do not spare anyone. No one's insulated from it. We as HUL are impacted by it. We try and deal with it. We don't have all the answers. We've all grown up with this, with a quote which you would have heard when we were all very young, that change is the only constant. And it must be true because it was first quoted by a Greek philosopher 2,500 years ago. So if that line could have stayed relevant for this period, it must be true. Change is indeed the only constant that we deal with. But there is something that has changed. And the thing that has changed is possibly the rate of change. And the frightening thought of all of that is that if that is the rate of change, that everything that we use today, which we feel is indispensable, was discovered in the last one generation or maybe two, just look ahead. The things that we feel we cannot live without will become redundant in our lifetimes. The only way to deal with it is to embrace change, to think of it as an opportunity, to be determined, to be resilient, to do the things which are required to ready ourselves for it. But we all know, we've all been in business. That's easier said than done. And the starting point of all of this is to develop what I call a point of view. A point of view on the future. A point of view on the future which is clear, is compelling, and then more widely shared within the organization. Now, where does this point of view come from? This point of view comes from a series of things that we observe, trends that we didn't see. And if I was to talk about trends, it is very likely that if I talk about several trends, there will be a very broad unanimity in terms of, yeah, we can see that these are the things that are going to happen in this world. If I was to say that the center of economic activity will move from the west to the east, yeah, sure it will. That urbanization will be a big trend, yes it will. That the global mobility is something that we are going to experience, of course it will. That the relentless pace of technology and the way it is spreading and the revolution that digital is going to cause, yeah, sure. I don't think anyone disagrees with any of this. The question then we have to ask ourselves is, these are the trends. It's not enough to leave it at these trends. You need to start filtering these trends. You need to start seeing and understanding the interplay of these trends and start understanding the implications that some of these might have on our business. The real challenge is not the intellectual challenge of developing a point of view or understanding or recognizing the implications. The real challenge is translating that in terms of what it means and dealing with the social, human aspects of skills, of insecurity, of shedding, which is required before you can embrace a new future which is going to take place. And then we said explicitly that the role of our leadership team must be to run this business with a bifocal lens. Why bifocal? Well, one part of it has to be focused about winning today. It is about making sure that the business remains competitive today. But that's only one lens. We need a second lens which we need to use simultaneously, a second lens which will make sure that we are taking the actions which are required to build a portfolio, build brands, build capabilities, which will ensure that we win in the future which we have a point of view on. It is only if we do this now will we future-proof this business and leadership perform the task which has been assigned to it. Now when I say this, many of you would say, but what's changed? This was always the role of leadership, which is to do things today which are right for our business, but also to do things to future-proof this business tomorrow. That's absolutely correct if you say that. But there's one thing which has changed, and that's the rate of change. And in the past, if you were to think of things 50 years ago or so, the things that you were doing today to win were not dramatically different from what you needed to do to win tomorrow. And you could evolve gradually from where you are now to where you need to be. And therefore, the tasks involved to do things to future-proof the business were not materially different and certainly not at a conflict with some of the things that you need to do to win today. That's the change which has happened. And the most significant and most dramatic impact that we see is likely to happen to our business and business model is because of the way consumers are changing, because of the way consumers are consuming media, the way consumers are consuming information and interacting with media. And you all in this business would know about this even more than I do, but I see this change happening all over the place. I'm deeply concerned that the models by which we have succeeded, the models by which our brands are engaged with consumers, may not just become less relevant, they might even become irrelevant. If I were to ask a brand manager to think of a world where a 30-second advertising didn't exist, he wouldn't know what to do. I certainly wouldn't know what to do because I grew up in an era where only this was relevant. So because of what's happening in the digital world, some fundamental premises have changed. The 30-second advertising worked on the premise that I had the opportunity to interrupt you in your entertainment and show you what I wanted, and that you would be willing to listen to it and watch it. That was the premise. The second premise was that I can get a very large audience to watch that same thing, and there was efficiency in putting a spot on television. But with the fragmentation of television and in the fact that people are moving out of television and into internet and other areas, etc., many of these assumptions are no longer true. And even those guys who continue to watch television now have this wonderful or horrible, whichever side you want to look at it, thing called the remote in their hands. And when the advertising comes, you know what you do? What do you do? Change channels. And yet, if everyone in this room is changing channels, why is it that we are not behaving and acting with a sense of crisis that 30-second advertising might be destroyed? Because what this is saying is consumers don't want to watch it. The rest of the guys are watching it because they don't have a choice. But if you did have a choice, you didn't want to be subjected to the interruption in your entertainment. That's what it's saying. And that's threatening our business. Knowing what to do is the relatively easier part. The transformation and change which is required requires a different form of commitment. And unless leaders in this room lead it from the front and have bold targets and commitments that you set for yourself, chances are you will not make the change as rapidly as you need to make. Even now I am not satisfied, I am not convinced that we are doing things adequately or fast enough to deal with this, and the only thing which gives me sleepless nights is the fact that the world outside will be changing much faster than we internally within the companies are changing to keep pace with all of them.